Hey guys, so I wanted to quickly film a spoiler update regarding NXT. Now, if you don't want to watch any spoiler videos, I completely understand, so I'm going to title it Spoiler. Honestly, I am so elated with this news that I just heard the other night. NXT has finally decided to create a secondary title for the men's division, which is amazing. I've been saying this for a solid year. William Regal came out at a Florida taping and he said that they are going to create a new title, which is going to be called the North American title. So in my opinion, the North American title, from what I've gathered, is very similar to the US title and the European title from the late 90s. I think that this is going to do wonders for a lot of the mid-card talent who kind of just stay stagnant in NXT, where they're not getting elevated to the main event level, but they're just kind of falling flat in dead-end storylines and they're not really doing anything. This is the perfect title for them. They can flirt with this title picture while they're in NXT until they get called up to the main roster. So if you guys don't know, William Regal did announce that there is going to be a six-man ladder match at NXT TakeOver New Orleans to determine the first ever inaugural NXT North American champion. So here's where it gets really, really interesting, because he has chosen six incredible talents to partake in this first ever match. We have the debuting Ricochet, EC3, as well as Velveteen Dream, Killian Dane, Adam Cole, and Lars Sullivan. All talents that I absolutely love. It is so hard for me to pick a favorite, and I am not going to pick a favorite of who I want to win yet. I will leave that up to my prediction video, which will be coming in a couple of weeks. But I just wanted to break the news to you guys because I think that this is a beautiful, beautiful idea that is long overdue for NXT, and I think it's great. It gives more people a chance to actually shine. Just take, for instance, a guy like Adam Cole, right? He is super ultra mega talented, but he's not flirting with that main event picture just yet. That's why I think like a mid-card title is really good for all these people that are kind of in the middle, where they're not being elevated, but they're not like lower card at all. They're in the dead in the middle. I love the mid-card. I've always been a big proponent of mid-card wrestlers. I feel like they are the backbone of wrestling. They're the ones that are day in and day out, killing it, working as hard as they possibly can to try and get that top spot. So they're always the ones that stick out very fresh in my mind, because I feel like they are putting in the hardest work, you know, trying to get better and better and better. They're not resting on their laurels like some main eventers. So that's why I love the mid-card so much, and I'm super happy with this news. I'm so excited. I don't think Regal could have chosen any better guys. I think all six are incredible mid-carders or higher main eventers that are going to be participating in this match. I honestly think any single one of them could win. I genuinely mean that. I could see each one winning, honestly, because they're all so fucking good. So let me know what you guys think. Who do you want to win that match? That's honestly my match that I'm most looking forward to for that weekend thus far. I am over the moon and super elated about it. I'm so excited, and I cannot wait to see it play out in person. I think it's going to be incredible. So let me know what you guys think, and don't forget to follow me on all my social media profiles. It will be all linked down in the description. I love you guys so much. Thanks for watching.